Tonight's amusements are accompanied by Pure Imagination Porter from Sucrum's Brewing in Winnipeg. They describe it as a sweet pastry porter that's inspired by pancake toppings. This beer is brewed with a generous amount of oats and has the addition of maple chocolate, hazelnut, salt, vanilla, and blueberries. Maple chocolate nutty beer. Huh. Yeah, it does taste mapley and nutty. That's interesting. So, tonight I am just going to relax and build a nice simple little kit. Because relaxing and building a simple little kit is exactly what I am in the mood for. In the kit we have a bunch of LEDs, we have three capacitors, we have three transistors, we have six resistors. Everything clustered in threes. I would bet that the LEDs are a multiple of three. Which isn't really a surprise, there are 12 LEDs on the board. So there's no description on the packaging. It's been sitting in my kit box for a while. What I'm pretty sure this is, just based on the smattering of components, I'm pretty sure that the LEDs are going to be clustered in groups of three, and then each of the three transistors turns on one cluster in turn. And then the three capacitors are probably acting as a timing element. The three 470 ohm resistors are likely going to be in series with the LEDs. And the three 10K resistors are probably going to be working alongside of those three capacitors as timing elements. So we'll just bring in the supplies we need. A soldering iron, some solder, MG Chemicals 6040, of course, and a stand to hold the board. I mean, there's any number of different ways that you could hold the board, but I am going to stick with this stand just because it's the best one that I've got around here, and it wasn't all that expensive. So, where do we start? I think maybe we should start with the resistors. So from the board, we saw that there was three 10Ks and three 470s. And these are the 470s that are bundled together. So I'm guessing that these ones that aren't bundled together are the 10Ks. Yep, that's exactly what they are, 10K. Right, that should be easy. Start with dropping in the three 10K resistors. Just because I don't have to strip them off the carrier tape. There's one up there and one there. And the third one is down at the bottom of the board. I'm guessing that's just due to layout constraints, trying to maintain it as a single-sided board. Because this is through-hole, I'm just using a fairly large tip. It doesn't need to be anything smaller than that. I'll just get busy here. First resistor's in. Yay! Next set, the 470s go in just as easily. He said not putting them in easily at all. Flip them up and give them a little bit of a bend on the backside just to hold them in place and quickly solder them down. Next, let's put in the capacitors. And I'm not even going to bother taking them off the tape. I'm just going to cut them loose. That way I don't have to worry about the tape gunk polluting the holes as they go through. And on the board, the marking, the shaded inside, matches the negative arrow on the side of the capacitors. So that just drops in there. And again, hold those in place while I flip it over and bend the legs just so that I can work with them easier. There we go. I suppose I could have trimmed those leads a little bit shorter when I was taking them off the carrier tape, but it doesn't matter when you get off there. All right, carrying on. Normally, I leave the semiconductors for last, but in this case, I've got both transistors and LEDs both of which technically are semiconductors. So I think I will do the transistors just because they sit in the middle of the board and the LEDs are around the edge and I can deal with them at the end. I'm going to have to splay the legs just a little bit to get them to fit through the holes properly. That one went in nicely. So when I was doing my kit builds at Christmas time, some people complained a little bit about neatness and tidiness. That's not really a high priority for me, especially when I'm doing something just for the fun of it. Yeah, I'm showing you guys, but that's my primary motivation is just to enjoy the process. The fact that you guys are along for the ride is just a bonus. Here we go. It looks reasonable. They're all connected. One downside about having tools start to become magnetic, when you've got these leads that are tinned ferrous metal of some sort, steel, I guess, they tend to stick. I know some people like magnetic tools and they have their place, but I'd prefer to have non-magnetic by default. That's just a preference. So we have a bunch of LEDs here. Where's a knife? I know it doesn't really matter, but I like to see what color the LEDs are. They are blue. Okay. So on the board, you see the LED footprints each have a flat spot on one side of them. The LED packages also have a flat spot. It's one leg's longer, one leg shorter. The short leg and the flat spot are the negative side. But since the marking on the board doesn't show positive or negative, I'll just go with the flat spot thing, right? Why not? This is where it gets a little bit tricky with the grabbers here, just because they get in the way. So I think I'll put in most of the LEDs and then solder them. And then I will move the grabber and deal with the remaining LEDs after that. Now that I have a choice to make, I can either stick the LEDs in just as deep as that little flat spot on the leads there, which is where they are right now, or I could jam them all the way through so that they're flush on the board. But I think I'm going to leave these ones sitting at that level, which is going to be a little bit trickier, but I'll manage, I think. They're all kind of wedged in there right now, so we'll just get to busy. And again, I'm going to solder just one leg on each of them initially. And then I'll come back and level them all out just to make sure that they haven't moved and stuff like that too much. Come on, you. Okay, that's them all in place. That guy is sitting a little bit high. Let's heat him up and push him back in. That one's a hair high, not enough that I would normally worry about it, but I'm sure somebody will see something. Okay, that's reasonable. And we'll quickly bang down the other side of those guys and then carry on. And actually, I think what I will do is flip this board around just to get at that side of it. Why would I want to do this the hard way? This is supposed to be fun. And now the trimmings. Right. Now then I'll just spin that board around and do the last two. This gets a little bit harder to grip it without damaging things, but I think I've got it there. Oh, and hey, they even included some extra LEDs. That's awesome. Where's my flat side here? That way. And short lead flat side that way. Right then, what's left? All that is left is to put the power pins on that corner, which is just a pair of DuPont pins, which are the hardest ones to hold in place because you can't really wedge them in. So we get out the secret weapon, blue tack. Ah, get back on there, you. Come on, ground pin solder. There we go. That'll do nicely. Right, that is the board soldering completed. I guess we should put some power at this thing and just see if it works. 5.5 volts on the power supply. This thing says anywhere from 2 to 12. So let's see what happens. Okay, power on. She's not oscillating really. So what do we have? Two sets of LEDs on and one not. One dimmer than the others. Okay. I'll have to take a quick look at the backside here, see if there's any bad solder joints. Do a little bit of troubleshooting. 0.6 volts, that transistor's base is turned on. 0.5, wait, minus 0.5? That ain't right. And this one is 0.2 of a volt, so it's partially turned on, which explains why some LEDs are on dim. But why is this one at a negative voltage? Ah, I see my screw up. Do you see it? Look closer. Do you see it now? How about now? Look at the silk screen underneath that guy. Oops. At least that should be an easy fix, I hope. If I didn't manage to destroy it, I should be able to just lift it out. Heat up two pads at once. Lever it out. There we go. Let's just see. No, it seems okay. Okay, let's try that again. They all came on briefly and then they all went out. So according to the schematic that I hastily drew while I was doing my troubleshooting, when the transistor is turned on, it basically shorts the LEDs to ground. So I would expect in this mode here, in this failure mode, that all three of the transistors are turned on. Means all the bases should be at about 0.6 volts. 0.457 on that one. 0.453 on that one. 0.289 on that one. So why? So what happens if we short one of those 10K resistors? There we go. It just needed a kickstart. So one of the things that these circuits need, this or the transistor flip-flop, it needs a little bit of an imbalance in one leg of the circuit when it comes up. Otherwise, it'll never start. So getting it started is the hard part if everything is perfectly balanced. All three base resistors are the same 10K, all the same timing capacitors. I don't even remember what they are. It doesn't matter. They're the same. That's all that's important. And the collector resistors are all the same. So nothing's imbalanced. When it comes up, they all come up to voltage at the same point and they all just kind of stall. So ideally, you would expect that there would be some variation in the resistors just from manufacturing tolerances, and that would be enough to get it to start on its own. But it didn't. those resistors must be all from the same batch and all fairly closely matched. So what I had to do to get it started was just short out one of those 10K pull-up resistors, which caused a hard pull-up on the base of, in this case, I did it on R5, which is this for this transistor here. And that was enough to throw the thing out of balance and get it to start oscillating. And now, as one of them turns on, the other two turn off, discharging the capacitor, and the capacitor charges back up again and turns them back on again. So that was interesting. It was fun putting it together. It's a little bit frustrating that I had made a stupid mistake in there, but so be it. And I'm actually surprised that the components are well enough matched just in a random Chinese kit that it wouldn't have started on its own. But there we go. Anyway, I hope that was interesting. Comments and questions down below. I'll talk to you later.